things will be added unto you. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, students. How are you all doing? Well, this is my first time celebrating the school mass with all of you. Father Grady had to go on a trip, so he asked me to substitute, and I'm happy to be here with all of you to celebrate this mass as we will be nourished by the Lord, and we will continue on this journey of faith, especially as we have sixth graders and kindergartners here together to celebrate this Mass. And so, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who through your Spirit raised up St. Teresa of Jesus to show the Church the way to seek perfection, grant that we may always be nourished by the food of her heavenly teaching and fired with longing for true holiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Romans. Brothers and sisters, what can we say that Abraham found, our ancestor according to the flesh? Indeed, if Abraham was justified on the basis of his works, he has reason to boast. But this was not so in the sight of God. For what does Scripture say? Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. A worker's wage is credited not as a gift, but as something due. But when one does not work, yet believes the one who justifies the ungodly, his faith is credited as righteousness. So also, David declares the blessedness of the person to whom God credits the righteousness apart from the works. Blessed are they whose iniquities are forgiven and whose sins are covered. Blessed is the man whose sin the Lord does not record. The Lord of the Word.
The response is, I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. Blessed is he whose fault is taken away, whose sin is covered. Blessed the man to whom the Lord imputes not guilt, in whose spirit there is no guile. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, joy of salvation. Then I acknowledged my sin to you. My guilt I covered not. I said, I confess my faults to the Lord, and you took away the guilt of my sin. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice, you just. Exult, all you upright of the heart. I turn to you, Lord, in time of trouble, and fill me with the joy of salvation.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, so many people were crowding together that they were trampling one another underfoot. Jesus began to speak, first to his disciples. Beware of the leaven, that is, the hypocrisy of the Pharisees. There's nothing concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. Therefore, whatever you have said in the darkness will be heard in the light, and what you have whispered behind closed doors will be proclaimed on the housetops. I tell you, my friends, do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but after that can do no more. I shall show you whom to fear. Be afraid of the one who, after killing, has the power to cast into Gehenna. Yes, I tell you, be afraid of that one. Are not five sparrows sold for two small coins? Yet not one of them has escaped the notice of God. Even the hairs of your head have all been counted. Do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. The Gospel of the Lord. So again, I'm glad to be here celebrating this Mass with all of you. And if you were listening to the Gospel, Jesus was speaking to his disciples and he called them his friends. And today we have the kindergartners and the sixth graders who are here together as faith friends. And what do faith friends do for each other? Well, you help each other on the journey of faith, right? Because you guys are preparing for sacraments, right? And then kindergartners, in about 2 years, what sacrament will you be receiving? Yes, you'll be receiving Holy Communion. And sixth graders, 2 years from now, what sacrament will you be receiving? Confirmation. So now you guys are on this journey together, learning to love Jesus, learning to be friends with Jesus, and helping each other to prepare and receive these special sacraments, which will help us to be better friends of Jesus. And we know that on this journey of faith, we sometimes have easy moments, we sometimes have hard moments. And we heard something else in the gospel, how Jesus told us to not be afraid. So today, as faith friends, you're going to have to help each other when you guys are afraid. And we can be afraid of many things. There's people who are afraid of heights, right? And then there's people who are afraid of dogs, right? There's people who are afraid of spiders. There's people who are afraid of snakes. There's people who are even afraid of the dark, right? So everyone is afraid of something. And when we are afraid, don't we sometimes feel alone? Don't we sometimes feel lost? Don't we sometimes feel like we can't do anything and we're helpless? So as faith friends, you're gonna have to help each other when you notice that your faith friend is afraid. And when you notice that they are afraid, you can share the words of Jesus in today's gospel. Because Jesus, at the very end, he says, "Do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows." Now, does everyone know what a sparrow is? Yeah, if you don't know, a sparrow is like a very, very small bird. And Jesus is telling us that we are worth more than many sparrows. How many of you think we're worth more than 100 sparrows? Raise your hand. How many of you think we're worth more than 1,000 sparrows? How many of you think we're worth more than 1,000,000 sparrows? How many of you think that we're worth more than even 1,000,000,000,000 sparrows? How many of you think we're even worth more than all the sparrows in the world? You see? That's how important we are in God's eyes. We are worth more than all the sparrows in the world. So we don't need to be afraid, because we're so important and we're so valuable in God's eyes that he will be with us when we are scared. He'll be with us when we feel alone. He will be with us when we don't know what to do. Jesus is the friend that we all have in common, who helps us to not be afraid. And today we celebrate a special saint, Saint Teresa of Avila, who's also called Saint Teresa of Jesus. And she is called a doctor of the church. And when the church calls a saint a doctor of the church, it's to let us know that her writings and her way of life was so important and so influential that if we even practice just a little bit of it, or if we read just some of her writings, that'll help us to grow in holiness and be better friends with Jesus. And Saint Teresa of Avila, she's from Spain, and she wrote this very special prayer to help people so they wouldn't be afraid and to let them know that God is always on their side. And the name of that prayer is Nada Te Turbe. Now, I won't say the whole prayer, but at the end of the prayer, I really like the last two lines, in which we are in the prayer, which is in Spanish. She says, "Quien a Dios tiene, nada le falta, solo Dios basta." And if we were to roughly translate that, it means whoever has God doesn't lack anything. Which means if you have God on your side, if you have God as your friend, if you have Jesus as the person who is close and near your heart, then you're not going to be missing anything, because God will give you everything that you need. And then the last phrase of the prayer, solo Dios basta, that means God is enough. And God isn't just enough. God is more than enough. Because God blesses you with your family. God blesses you with your friends. God blesses you so you're here in this school, so you can love him. God gives you more than what you need. And so in that very special prayer, it begins with Nada Te Turbe, which is one way of saying, do not be afraid. Because God is enough, and if you have God in your life, then you'll have everything that you need. So as we continue this Mass, as faith friends and as friends of Jesus, let us remind each other to not be afraid. And let us remind each other that we are worth more than many sparrows. You all are very important in God's eyes. And if you keep God in your heart, then he will give you everything that you need, and you'll realize that his love is enough for you, it's enough for me, and it's enough for the whole world. Amen? Amen.
Prayers of the faithful. For Pope Francis and all church leaders, that they lead us with love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the students and teachers at our school, that we spread kindness daily, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, that they are comforted by prayers and loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they are in heaven with Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And right now, before we continue, I want you to take a moment of silence to tell Jesus your special intention. Go ahead and ask him for anything that you want. So we'll take this moment of silence, telling God what we would like to receive from him. We pray to the Lord. God Almighty Father, you love us and you treat us so well in your mercy and your kindness. And because we are worth more than many sparrows, we know that you will receive our intentions and answer them according to your will. May we receive these graces with joy and continue to love you as friends. This we ask you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us be seated and prepare for the offertory. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Let us receive this water and wine. May we come to share in the divinity of Christ, the ultimate self to share in our humanity. Thank you so much. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. My iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May our offerings, O Lord, be acceptable to your majesty, to whom the devoted service of Saint Teresa was pleasing in such great measure, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church in recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, they become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Anthony and Saint Teresa of Jesus, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your Pilgrim Church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, Enrique, his auxiliary bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ be saved for eternal life. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord our God, that your obedient family, whom you have fed with the bread of heaven, may follow the example of Saint Teresa and rejoice to sing your mercies for all eternity, through Christ our Lord. It was really a privilege and honor to be here and celebrate Mass with you. I really hope that you feel blessed and you remember that you are Jesus's friend. You are worth more than many sparrows, so you do not need to be afraid. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.